Our top story at 6 o'clock, the escape of a Santa Cruz County inmate. And tonight, new information about the Sheriff's Department's policies that ultimately at least contributed to a four-hour standoff for Maurice Ainsworth. Tonight, Action News has learned that Ainsworth, who is 6'7" tall and 270 pounds, was assigned a female deputy, a deputy half his size. Action News reporter Felix Cortez kicks off our live team coverage with what the Sheriff's Department is saying today about their transport policies.
Well, Aaron, today the sheriff telling us that Maurice Ainsworth planned his escape. The sheriff also saying that the system designed to protect the public failed.
Question was, are we going to review our policy? And absolutely we are.
At a news conference Tuesday, Santa Cruz County Sheriff Phil Wowak said the system for transporting inmates to and from the hospital failed Monday afternoon. This after an inmate broke free from his security detail and terrorized a nearby neighborhood.
We believe that the system that we had in place was appropriate at the time. Now we're looking at it and saying we need to reevaluate that. We need to potentially have two deputies in medical transports. It's a challenge for us. It's a challenge in the staffing that we have.
Sheriff Wowak said he believes Maurice Ainsworth planned his escape. He went to Dominican Hospital for an MRI, which meant he had to be unshackled. When Deputy Kathy Bramante went to put them back on, a struggle ensued. Ainsworth overpowered Bramante, took her taser, tasered her, then fled with her gun. The inmate is 6'7", 274 pounds. The deputy, 5'3", and half his weight. The sheriff said he wasn't going to second guess his deputy's actions. Co-workers praised Bramante's bravery.
We're incredibly proud of her actions. She was heroic in her actions and staying in the fight and doing everything in her power and beyond to bring the suspect into custody.
But the sheriff said clearly there was a challenge Monday afternoon, and security measures, he said, will change.
I think that's a good idea, that they should look at whatever policies they have in place and see how those can be possibly altered if they need to be.
Officials with Dominican Hospital released a statement today saying they will meet with the sheriff's office and others to share ideas on how to best handle inmates who are patients at the hospital. Reporting from Santa Cruz, I'm Felix Cortez. Aaron, back to you in the studio.
All right, Felix, is there any indication what he was needing the MRI for? Was that any indication of what the problem was?
You know, we don't know that at this time. That wasn't brought up at today's news conference, but it's a pretty good guess that whatever it was, Maurice Ainsworth probably faked an illness in an effort to get to the hospital, in an effort to get that MRI. And as I said, when he went for that MRI, he had to be unshackled, and that's where he probably saw his freedom.
That's what I was kind of sort of getting at, Felix. It seemed like he had planned this, that he knew exactly, you know, what was the best means for him to get there.
And you know, Aaron, the sheriff did mention that they had no indication to believe that Ainsworth was a problematic inmate or posed any risk. In fact, they said that Ainsworth had been to the hospital the previous week before.
All right, Felix, thank you.